Hi, in this video I'm going to have a look at the game Cut the Rope 2. I haven't actually played part 1, so for me this was all still quite new. And the concept is, I find the concept quite nice. It is quite different from what I've seen before. A lot of other similar games out there, and this one stands out a bit from that point of view. The idea is that we have this figure here. We can cut the rope it's attached to, and the idea is that it should catch those stars and then end up in the mouth of this green monster. Well, now it is very easy because they're all on top of each other, so we don't, and there is only one rope, so we just do like that and then the level is finished. Three stars, and with this button we can go to the next level. Now here we have two ropes that attach the figure, so it is already starting to be a bit more difficult. Well, if we would cut this, nothing much would happen. So let's try to do that one, and then we see, okay, it caught those two stars, and it ends up in the mouth. So it does use gravity, as you can see, to move down. Now here there are a lot of ropes. And the idea is we can cut this one, and if we cut this one, the ball will roll down here and roll back, I hope. And yes, that's what it does. You have to be careful. You're inclined to just click on start, but actually if you do that, you start a premium membership, and that starts maybe with a free trial, but I have the feeling that it goes automatically to payment, so we're not going to do that. I'm going to play a bit more. This already seems a bit more difficult to me. Oh, I cut it too early. So not as easy. I mean, you might have a plan. This time I did have the good plan, but I didn't. I should have cut it later. I mean, cut it when it started to move back. Also, not cut it too late, because then it would roll over the last star. So in this, and now it's not that bad. I had a feeling that when I was playing it on my iPad earlier, it was a lot worse. But this game does have a lot of advertisements in between. And that is a bit of a pity. What is nice is they do have new functionality as you progress through levels. So that is quite nice. You can click it now, then the balloon pops and it will fall down. So I think I've already showed enough, and I'm already getting a bit annoyed. And as I said, on my iPad it was worse. So there seems to be a lot of pushing, a lot of advertisement here. That's not that bad yet. On my iPad, I was really having the feeling I'm watching more advertisements than I'm playing the game. And also this premium membership is pushed a lot. So that's, to me, a bit of a pity. I think the game is quite nice. It is different from other games, which is always, that in itself is always good. I wish they had found another way to monetize this with in-game purchases, and not yeah, not having to push it so much, because this really, for me, this really prevents me from wanting to investigate it further. Because of that, I only give it 6 out of 10 stars. Okay, thanks for watching this video, and if you have any comments or any questions, that is always much appreciated. Bye.